Okay, and then number nine, you really want to care for your clothes. So get a great detergent, stain remover, dryer sheets, starch, shoe polish, an iron, and water protection spray for your shoes because those are the things that you're going to need in your supply kit to take great care of your clothes. Then I would get hangers in all the same size and with those slip grips on them. Those huggable hangers are amazing. They're kind of expensive, and I really want some, so I'm going to save up so I can get some. And then you're going to want to use, I like to anyway, get some clear bins, and you can get them from the dollar store. You can get packs of like five from the dollar store, even Target. And these are small clear bins that you can either put your shoes in, like if you, that's how you like to organize your shoes, you like them to be all in boxes, or you can put like little miscellaneous items in there, like socks, roll up your belts, clutch purses, and stuff like that. You put those in that kind of bag. Then I would say get some hooks for your purses. You can see on the back of my wall, I have some hooks up there, and then on my door, I have some hooks for my purses too. So I think that's really important, and you can put them up yourself. I mean, it really is not a tough thing. I put up all the hooks that I have by myself, and those, the ones on my door behind me, are just hooks. They hang on the top of your door. So, next, when you are shopping, another thing I forgot to mention. You want to ask yourself questions before you buy an item, especially if it's something that's kind of a splurge item. Like, what can I wear with this? You need to at least be able to wear the piece of clothing with three outfits, three things that you already have in your closet, not things that you need to go out and buy more of. Does it look good and does it feel good? I know sometimes you get into this thing where, you know, oh my gosh, this is really trendy, this is really in, I really want it, but it might not really look good on you. And that's the most important thing. Like, some things that I show in my videos, they might not look good on everybody. And just like when I see other people's videos, I'm like, oh my gosh, that's so cute, but I know it's not gonna work for me. So really, you know, you really have to be objective and say, does this look good on me? And does it feel good? It shouldn't be digging into your stomach or, you know, digging into your shoulders. That's just gonna be uncomfortable and you're not gonna wear it. And then the cost per wear is gonna go down. So, another thing that Katherine Finney said in her book is that everything should be under $5. Well, she said $3, but I just say $5. Everything should be under $5 when it comes down to cost per wear. So how often are you wearing this piece? How often are you going to wear this thing? Like when you're buying an expensive flat iron. Okay, I flat iron my hair once a week, for example. There are 52 weeks in a year. 52 divided by, I'm not good at math, but let's say it's a $100 flat iron. Divided by 52 is, what, like $2 or something? That's $2 every time I use it. So that's really cheap, and I don't know, that math was probably wrong. I don't know, but do you guys get what I'm saying? You divide how many times you're gonna wear an item by how much it costs, and that's how you get the cost per wear. And you also need to ask yourself, is this your style? Because sometimes, like I said, you see stuff on someone else, you're like, oh my God, that looks really great on her. But it might not really be your style, and you might like it on that person, and you like how they put it together, but you not might not really like it for your everyday life. Now, I would store special jewelry in separate containers. Like, for example, I put my watch in this container, and I store it in a drawer. Because some things, especially if they're cheap, the metal will rub with other metal, and it'll start to get that really gross coppery color. And if you spend a significant amount of money on jewelry, you do not want it to look bad, you know? And then hand wash your delicates like undergarments, lace underpants, bras, Spanx, tights. You need to hand wash those because they are the delicate things and they have elastic in them, so the elastic's gonna stretch in the dryer. And if you spend a lot of money on those things, because especially Spanx and bras, because I know those are expensive items, you are gonna be really mad if they get ruined in the dryer. And then my number 10 tip is to organize your closet. Because if you keep your closet organized, and that'll help you in the future, that'll really help you make like good decisions about what things you need to buy for your wardrobe. Hopefully I can do a closet organization video, and when I do it, it will be down in the bottom bar. So check out that. And also remember to email me with your questions, subscribe to my channel. I really love hearing from you guys. Add me as a friend on Facebook, and actually this is my actual Facebook. It's not my, like, you know, my, you know how some people do those things where you just can like them, like it's a group. It's not a group, it's my actual Facebook. My real, my, you know, at-home friends are on there and everything. So I hope you guys really enjoy this video, and thank you so much for watching. Bye!